Here's a question. What to do when you don't have enough wall sockets for your appliances? Most people would probably say to simply use a power strip, but not according to AliExpress logic, because there you can get such an adapter that you can screw into a light bulb fixture to turn it into an outlet that you can now use in the dark. Yeah, AliExpress is wild. And if you're completely confused right now, let me tell you that it's a Chinese online store where you can get the newest, weirdest, but also sometimes super useful products. But since you never exactly know whether the products are really a hidden gem or simply garbage, I created this video series. And today I got 7 more intriguing looking products to check out, including this weird adapter. And at the end, I will tell you whether you should check them out as well or stay away from them. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, who has been a leader in the PCB manufacturing industry for 18 years now. And their latest advancement, multicolored silkscreen PCBs, allows for greater design creativity and visual customization. And this Christmas, they are making it even easier to utilize this feature by offering a $10 discount coupon on designs created with EasyEDA Pro. So click the link below to learn more about this limited time offer and unlock new creative possibilities. Now let's get started with the most promising product I got for this episode, which is this 3-in-1 tool that is simultaneously an oscilloscope, multimeter, and signal generator. And I know that at a price of 74 euro, it is not super cheap, but even when you buy really cheap versions of each tool included, you would probably not get that low of a price. And of course, you not only get the tool in the box, but also two decently looking oscilloscope probes, multimeter probes, a USB-C cable, and a user manual that truly explains all details. Now the main reason why I'm excited about this thing is because due to its size and internal battery, it is super portable, which you cannot say about most scopes. This makes it a perfect companion for projects away from your workbench. Only question now is whether it works like advertised. And after playing around with the user interface for a while, I was pleasantly surprised. You see, not only does it boot super fast, but it also reacts snappy, the screen is bright and can be clearly seen from many angles, and for the most part, it is pretty intuitive to use. I said for the most part because unlike the multimeter mode, which is easy to access, it took some cumbersome navigating to find the two signal generator functions. But besides that, really nice. And this trend continued while I tested the features of the oscilloscope. It seems like you can easily view and capture all kinds of waveforms on both input channels. It even works with high frequencies like that of a switching power supply. But if we want to get precise, then around 35 MHz is the max for sine waves and around 15 MHz for square waves. And initially I thought you would have to use the cursor function to measure, for example, amplitude and frequency of your waveforms. But then I luckily found the measurement mode, which is not 100% precise, but definitely good enough, meaning this oscilloscope is definitely suitable for portable projects. That also includes the multimeter mode, which in comparison to my expensive multimeter, definitely delivers good enough precise values. And last but not least, we got the signal generator mode, which was honestly the weakest part, because fine adjusting the voltage and frequency was only possible in big steps, and the max frequency was also pretty low. But either way, I think this tool is super useful, and I of course also checked all of its other features that didn't fit in this mini review, and they all seem to work perfectly fine, meaning this thing is truly a hidden gem for me. But moving on to something probably way worse, which is this E27 to socket adapter that you can get for around 2 euro, and it comes with an almost as high review score as the oscilloscope from before. What the hell? And I know what you're thinking, why would you use that? And honestly speaking, the only idea I have is that you want to use it if you only have light outlets outside, but want to power a light strip. But back in the old days, similar devices were quite common, because there were simply not many wall sockets out there. But anyway, at first sight, this adapter seems to work like intended. But I quickly noticed that it grabbed the inserted plugs horribly, and leaves way too much wiggle room. I mean, there's not really any protection against contact given here, and the inner life metal is also way too easy to touch. And while opening this thing up, I also noticed that the use wires are pretty thin, which got me wondering how much current this thing can handle. For comparison, a normal German wall socket is rated for 16 amps, but while looking through the product description of the adapter, I found no current rating. The only information I found was that it can handle 200C, which I can in fact confirm. So to test the current rating, I simply let an increasing current flow through this thing, and to my own surprise, it did survive 16 amps. But it did get quite hot while doing this job, and overall, if we put all the facts together, then I would highly advise to not use such an adapter, mostly due to safety reasons. Next, I got myself this ESP-based relay board that can be used for home automation, and which you can get with an enclosure for around 25 euro. Now this product, like many other, got recommended to me by my Discord community, and they seem to know me well, because I love doing home automation with my Raspberry Pi here and Home Assistant. And it seems like this board supports Home Assistant, and can apparently be used with tons of other applications. So I looked through its incredibly long product description, only to find no example code, firmware or similar. For that, I had to visit the website of the manufacturer, who apparently offers dozens of different variations of home automation boards. There I not only found an official and promising looking firmware, but also Arduino code examples and the YAML file for ESP Home, which I needed to integrate this board into Home Assistant. So I powered it up with 12 volts and connected the board to my computer to flash the blank ESP Home firmware, to which I then uploaded the given code. And as you can see, that worked out perfectly, because I can not only control the relay outputs, but also see its digital input states. This way, you could, for example, easily control different lights in your home. And this is only one of many features this board offers. However, I didn't have time to test the rest extensively. But I bet it all works just fine, because they not only share the schematic of this thing, but also talk about each hardware detail extensively and how to use it. Combine that with the fact that the quality of the board is quite nice, and the enclosure of this thing can be easily mounted inside a distribution box, and I gotta say that I would recommend this thing, if you're a bit familiar with programming. And by the way, the only real negative aspect for me was that the pin headers were not labeled. But anyway, the next product I got is this high precision Milli Ohm Meter that you can get for around 30 euro, so not super cheap. But I really needed one, because when working with power electronics, then you oftentimes encounter rather small resistances that you need to accurately measure. Or you simply want to find out the resistance of your utilized connector, so that you know how much current it can handle before turning into a fire hazard. To find that out, I so far always let a big current flow through such a setup and then measure the voltage drop across it, in order to manually calculate the resistance. Or we can use the four-wire method of this multimeter here, to also more or less accurately measure the resistance, which in this case was not really accurate, because it was just too tiny. And let's not talk about how expensive this multimeter is. So I hope this little gadget here can be a decent low-budget alternative, and all we have to do to use it is to power it with 9 volts, clip the given wires together to calibrate it, and then attach the wires to the resistance we want to measure. And as you can see, the connector resistance is also too tiny for this thing. But when comparing my expensive meter with this low budget version using more common small resistor values, then I gotta say that I was quite happy with its accuracy. I mean, the max difference I noticed was around 10 milliohm, which is good enough for me. So yeah, this thing gets a recommendation from me, even though I'm still looking for a simpler way to measure the resistance of my connectors. But moving on to this liquid electrical tape, of which you can get 30 milliliters of for around 2.3 euro. And I was really excited to give it a try and insulate my exposed copper wires more easily. But guess what? This will be my fastest review so far, because the content of this tube was already partly hardened, and thus I could not use it anymore. Meaning this gets a big thumbs down, because this is something that should not happen. So let's hope the next item will be better. But I doubt it, because it is this belt sander adapter for your angle grinder that you can get for around 7 euro. Now I got interested in this thing because I don't have a belt sander in my workshop yet. But I immediately regretted buying it, because securing it to my angle grinder felt sketchy, and it took me around 20 minutes and lots of fiddling around to properly get it on there. After that though, it did work pretty much like you would expect it to. However, I noticed that the sandpaper got dull pretty quickly, meaning you would have to reorder new ones constantly. And even worse, the big plastic part of this adapter already got partly destroyed after my first usage, because it is not made for this kind of pressure. So long story short, get yourself a proper grinding wheel for your angle grinder and forget about this adapter. And with that being said, we come to the last product, which is this digital microscope that you can get for around 17 euro. Now I got interested in it because when working with small ICs, I oftentimes cannot read the labels on them, and thus I either have to use my smartphone or my big microscope here to properly read it, which takes a bit of time to set up. So I thought this thing could be a small and handy to have around solution for this problem, but I quickly realized that it was not. Now first off, the magnification factor is too big, and thus lets you not easily read labels, which was honestly suggested otherwise by the product pictures. And even worse is that you have to put this thing flat onto the surface to get the objects into focus, which does work for some circuit boards, but certainly not most of them. That really makes it a deal breaker for me, meaning once again, a big thumbs down. And just like that, we had a closer look at 7 more interesting products, and I certainly found some useful stuff that I will continue to use in the future. But don't worry, there is still lots more to explore. So, like always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to not miss the next episode. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.